They look weird, they feel weird, but I have to. So we shall see if I can go out like this or if I need to wash my face. Well, hello, my beauties, and welcome to my second birthday haul try on. Yes, that's what I'm going to do today because I got this. So that's what I'm going to use today, and I still have a foundation I need to test out. So yes, I'm going to do that as well. So I have it here from Kiko Milano, and yeah, I think that's about it. We're just going to have fun. So let me kind of do a little bit of Dr. Pawpaw on my lips. Let's prep the eyes. I think I'm going to start with the eyeshadow because I have no idea about the fallout. I should have because I watched plenty of videos on this palette, but still. I just forget, so yes. Let me do that real quick. This is the Catrice Camouflage Cream Pot. And the color is Ivory. Okay. And to be quite honest, I'm actually liking these, so yes. I'm going to put them on. A little bit higher, I think, today. They look weird, they feel weird, but they're quite handy, actually. Why don't you stick there? Stick there. And I've seen a lot of tutorials on this. Ever since I saw it, I actually wanted it, but it was quite pricey. And then they had a sale. 40% off eyeshadow palettes, and this one was included as well, so I got this quite, well, affordably, whatever. But yeah, so here it is, in case you have not seen it. I do want to do more looks with this. Let me know if you want me to do a 3 looks with this palette as well. I know there are a lot of those out there, but maybe, I don't know, I can bring something new to the table. I had a plan, I just don't know what it was anymore. To be honest. Wow. So, give me a minute.
5 minutes later.
Okay, so I think I have it. I'm really, really gravitating towards the color Phone Home, this one. So let's get Morphe M514 brush in the color Phone Home. It could very well be that I'm going to cut the crease as well. I'm not really sure yet, to be honest with you. So let me move my mirror in. Let me kind of zoom you in a little bit. It is quite kick-up-y in the pan. Let's place the shadow. I'm using tapping motions and oh my lordy lord. Wow. Packs quite a punch, doesn't it, this shade? Also want the color down. And I'm stopping there. These shadows blend out so easily, it's just insane. But, you know, to be quite honest, I wasn't expecting anything less from this palette. And this palette, normally full price, retails for 51 euros. And when a palette is that price, I kind of have expectations, you know? Does that make any sense? Okay, so that is down. I do want to deepen this up. Let me see if I can deepen it up with its own color first. So I'm grabbing a smaller brush. This is the M562. It's still quite fluffy though. So let's see what we can do. I'm not hating this at all. So I can actually nicely build up the shade with itself, which is good. I do, however, want a little bit of the color Area 51. I will show it. It's this gorgeous purple. Very lightly on the brush. Because I just want, I know I'm going to cut the crease on that height. I just want a little bit of darkness there. Because that is why I love how a cut crease looks, that you get that sharp line, you know? I think that's really pretty. You don't have to cut the crease for that. to be quite honest, but sometimes it makes it easier. So there's a very, very light layer of that purple. I'm just going to change brushes. So I have here my Morphe E36. I'm going to use that one in the color Area 51. Oh, and if you hear shooting outside, that is actually, I don't know if it picks up on camera, but that's normal because we have a naval base here and they are just practicing on the shooting range and you can hear that here. So don't be alarmed, it's all good. Just going to clean this brush off a little and I'm going to take a little bit of the color Phone Home, the first color. Just going to blend that a little bit here. And I do have to say though, I'm actually, this brush, 506, I think it is, in the color Area 51. I actually thought that this color would be darker. That dark purple. I don't know why, but that's what I thought. So first impression on this dark purple is, to be quite frank, I have purples that are darker. Am I making any sense? So yeah, okay, let's leave it at that and do the same on the other eye. Yes, let's do that. Okay, let me get a little bit of the color Black Hole, and that one, because it's just not as dark as I wanted in the outer corner. This is a very, very good black, so I tapped in really, really lightly. And as you can see, I'm really concentrating that on the outer corner. Now I'm going to kind of blend it a little. Just lightly. Kind of flicking it in so that it can mesh. I don't know how to explain this. Okay, I'm using this brush and I've dipped it into the black, and what I'm actually doing is just tapping. Stippling, actually. So I'm kind of stippling it on my eye. I don't know, it gives a nice effect, to be honest. I wasn't planning on doing something this smoky, but apparently I was. So let me get a brush and I'm going to cut the crease. I have here one from, what is it? A liquid camouflage high coverage concealer from Catrice. Does not really matter. So yes. I'm taking it a little bit higher in the inner part of my eye. I'm not going to cut the entire crease though. It's about half cut crease. I'm actually stopping here where I have that black. And I'm tapping with my finger a little bit on top of that edge. Like so. Okay. I'm cleaning that brush that I used. And I'm going to tap over the concealer to pick up any extra product. And it kind of helps to stop against creasing. Okay. Let's do the other crease. Yes, yes. Okay, even-ish. I'm going to take this brush again into the color Black Hole, which is obviously the black, tapping it off. I'm just going to go stipple a little bit on the edge. Yes, I'm still going to use Pluto, so let me get a brush into the color Pluto, which is this one. I want to use that on the cut crease part, the concealer part. It's dry. Not as pink as I thought it would be though, but let me put it on the other eye first. Tapping over the black a little. Thank you. I'm actually curious what it does wet, but I need a different brush for that, or I want a different brush for that. Let me get this one. So I have here a smaller flat brush. Going into the color Pluto again. But now I'm going to spray. I think it really makes a difference. Or are my eyes deceiving me? It looks like the yellow that's in that color is shining through more when I wet the shade. But it is a freaking pretty color though. I want that underneath my eye as well. Oh, I think the cards were not really... Let me see what they did. Yeah, it's okay. But it is the last time that I can use these. I am done with the eyes for now. I'm going to think about something. Oh no, wait. Where's my small brush? Yes. In the color area 51, which is the purple, underneath the eye here. I'm going to put the alien palette away. I'm going to prime the face for the under eyes. Okie dokie. And I have here a brush. I'm going to go into the, what is it called again? The 1 Minute Face Perfector from Catrice. I freaking love this stuff. Especially on days where I don't want to wear makeup. I have those days. I don't feel like it, you know. Or at least I don't want to wear foundation. And then I smear this stuff all over my face. And then a little bit of concealer if I think I need it. And call it a day. Alright, feeling with my fingers if I have put enough on. I can sometimes use a little bit extra here. And it smooths the face and... It doesn't make it sticky, but it keeps my foundation in place and it doesn't make my face feel silicone-y. It just feels nice. So I'm, yes. Okay. So now I have the foundation. I don't really know how I want to apply it. So I have here this brush. I also have this brush, which I do like for foundations, which is technically a highlighter brush though. Anyway, and I have a sponge, so I can go either number of ways. This is the Skin Tone Foundation from Kiko Milano in the color Neutral 10. I got shade matched, so let's see. It is quite a runny formula. So let's start with this brush first. I don't know. Let's pick a little bit up and then stipple it and see what it does. It does have a scent. It's not really overpowering though, but... And I personally like to bring foundations underneath my eye as well. I just give, that gives me some extra coverage. Okay, so I do have a little bit of brush strokes. So I'm going to take my sponge. Ooh, that's nice. And my sponge actually didn't soak up a lot. Well, actually, almost nothing at all, to be honest. So it's just... Wow. It looks like skin. It's very pretty. Let's see if I can build it up. I'm going to use the sponge. The sales lady said that I could build it up to, I think, a medium. Oh my, it feels like I have nothing on my skin. And I think the shade matches really, really good as well. Wow. Let's do the forehead with the sponge. Let's see what it does. Yeah, then I get a really sheer coverage, okay. So I'm taking my brush first. Kinda, you know, distribute it and such. At least if I want a little bit of more coverage. I have a lot on my forehead now for my taste, but let's go over it and press it all in. Yeah, I like this way better. I do have to say I'm on my third pump. Well, yeah, almost. That's because it is a liquidy foundation. I kind of want to see what the foundation does as well. So I'm using more than I normally would. So again, I distributed it, and let's just kind of make it neater. The foundation looks like skin. It's not full coverage. It is a very, very light medium, I think. But I knew that when I bought it, because I wanted, I talked with her, I wanted a foundation that felt comfortable and that looked like skin. But wow. And I didn't bring it down my neck. Wow. It feels a little bit sticky still, which isn't that weird, I think. It's creasing underneath my eyes, but there, almost everything is creasing under my eyes. So far, I'm impressed. Let's see how it plays with others, shall we? So let's get a concealer. Sometimes I bring it a little bit down because I have redness there. So sometimes I just like to use concealer on top of my cheeks to kind of hide that redness. So let me put on the... Wait, let me zoom you in first so you can see how it is looking. It still feels tacky, so I'll probably need to set it. But I'm going to put on the rest of my face, and then I will be back, and we can finish off the eyes and all that goodness, and then lippy and that stuff. So yeah, hold on tight. I'll be right back. Okay, so something is happening underneath my eyes as well, and I think it is the foundation, because I've used the concealer in combination with that under eye primer on numerous occasions, and I did not have a problem. But I also put the foundation on top of that, and it seems to be kind of breaking up underneath my eyes. It's also caking, starting to cake up here, so yeah. The rest of my face does look good. You know, the weird thing was that it actually looked really, really nice until I powdered. So, yeah, you know, I just have to keep trying out this foundation. And, yeah, let you know. Let's use, for funsies, because I can, the color Pluto, this one, as a highlighter shade as well. So I'm dipping my highlighter brush in. Tapping off. Not too shabby. I kind of wanted to do something different, you know? Let's first kind of smoke out the lower lash line. So I'm taking the color Phone Home on a brush. To be honest, I only placed it, so let's take a different brush and smoke it out. I cannot buff with stiff brushes. I tried, I just cannot. Yes, I lost a little bit of darkness there, didn't I? So let me get a brush with a point into area 51. I'm just going to trace here where I lost a little bit of that purple. And I don't know what it is doing, but it is away there. It's gone there. I don't know why. So let's get a little bit of that purple first and pack it on. And then the black. Yes, okay. Cleaning the brush. I'm just going to go here. Kind of blending a little bit. to kind of soften this edge a tiny bit. Yes. What do I want for the inner corner? I can do something. I have an itchy ear, so yeah. I can do something different. I just don't know if it will look good. Because I had an idea in mind. I just don't know if it will go with the rest of the look. So we shall see if I can go out like this or if I need to wash my face. But I want the color Alien in my inner corner. So I cleaned my tiny brush. I'm going to plop this here. But I also left a little bit open here. I'm going to do something with that later. Or in a minute, I just want to place that green first. Oh, this is such a pretty color. I kind of basically want to bathe in it. I'm taking this brush. I'm just going to kind of dip my brush in. Kind of. And dragging it a little bit on top of that very, very, yeah, that lighter color that we put down first. So I'm basically blending them together. Oh, and I think that's really pretty. Okay, so let's do the same. Try to do the same with my eyelid. I just don't know how to hold my brush then. Oh, I like that. So let's do the same on the other side then. See, are we? I'm basically now smoking out my lash line with that same shimmery green. Yes, me like. Yes. It is, do I dare? Sure, why not? Let's get that same shimmery green. A little bit of phone home. I flick this up with my finger just a tiny bit. I kinda have. Really? You fucker. What the hell is it with this purple? I don't know why, but that purple, I keep losing that purple, which is weird. And I know some colors are a little bit more difficult. But I think it is the combination that these blend really, really well because they're soft, but it is also a purple. So it kind of gets lost on my eye a little bit. I don't know. Anyway, what I'm going to do is plop on a little liner, an eye pencil, and mascara. That's what I'm going to do. So hold on tight. Don't go anywhere. I'll be right back. Okay. I don't know how much it shows, but I put a purple mascara on the bottom. But yeah, anyway, a liner and a mascara are on. I need to plop on my falsies and choose a lippy. Maybe I will. I'm going to think about, because I want to use the Kiko Milanos today, I'm going to think about if I'm brave enough to do this one. But you will see that in a minute, what I have decided. I'm going to plop on falsies and lippy, and then I will be right back. So, apparently I was brave enough for black mascara. But here is the finished look, and what I did, besides the falsies, which are the Sosu falsies in style Kylie, I actually, this one from ColourPop, it's the purple one, in Purple Pros, I plopped on my bottom lashes, but I also, I don't know if you can see it on camera, also used it on the, to coat well the top lashes and my falsies. So I think that adds a little bit extra. So yeah, I ordered a few. I know though that they sell at least a dark blue in stores here. Just a darker blue. So maybe I will check that one out as well. And maybe I can also find a dark green here in store. Because ColourPop did not have a dark green, or at least I did not order a dark green. So yeah, but here is the finished look. And I feel kind of not really alien princessy, but I don't know, I'm getting dragon vibes today. I don't know why, it's just the vibe I am getting. So yeah, this was, well, my birthday haul part two. And let me go over what I used. I used a lot that I used in the first haul. And the falsies are fantastic. I have actually worn these falsies for a few times now. They're really comfortable, really, really pretty. I will give you an update, however, on this one that I used in the first one, in the first video. It cracks, so that's not good. But if I put a gloss on top, it stays actually for a really freaking long time on my lips. Same with the pink one. The pink one cracks as well. But when I paired it with the NYX Butter Gloss in pink macaroon, it stayed on so freaking long, and then it's really pretty and really comfortable. Obviously it transfers then, but yeah, it is what it is. And this is a black. I can, for funsies, put this one on top, which is from Wet n Wild in the color Pastel Grunge, just because I can. And then it really transforms it. Yeah, now I actually think it goes even better with the look that I have. So yeah, I do have to be quite honest with these. I wore this one yesterday and it kind of dried out my lips after a few hours. And it wore away in the more towards my mouth. Does that make any sense? So it does that. Are they the best formula that I have ever used? No, they're also not the worst. They're okay. The eyeshadow palette. The purple is a bit finicky. It's a weird purple. So if you have any tips on the purple, let me know. And this is a trouble spot on my eye for me. But yeah, I can get most shadows to stick. And I can see that it is kind of, you know, I don't know if you can see it, rubbed away again. So maybe I need to try a different primer underneath. I did not set the base, but, well, technically I did because I put down shadow, didn't I? Maybe I need to try a different eyeshadow primer. That could be it. But yeah, let me know down below if you have any tips or tricks on the shadows of the Alien palette. And I'm, well, going to play with it more. Probably going to do a 3 looks video. I think there's a palette bingo collab coming up with this palette as well. So yeah, this is not the last time that I have used this palette. The foundation I need to test out more, because now it's looking really nice, and in the beginning, before it had really set, it was kind of looking, after I powdered it, kind of looked like it was breaking up, which is kind of weird. Doesn't seem to do that now though. So I'm going to test it out with different powders and setting, not setting. And I don't know, no eye primer maybe. I'm going to test it out and then I'm going to do a review video on it. That's about it, I think, yes. If you have any tips and tricks for me, please leave them down in the comment section below. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. And that's basically it, I think. Yeah, I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. And I'll be seeing you soon in my next one. Bye, guys.